Welcome back to Make It Last Forever. We bless God. Once again, we have gathered talking about finances, how we will be free from financial difficulties as a couple. I believe the other time, by the grace of God, God used a great man of God to explain so much. He gave us an idea. He gave us how we should go by the value that God has given unto us, to the marketplace. And thank God, he is in studio here today too. And I'm blessed. I always tell you, anytime that I see this man of God, I'm so excited because I know I'm taking so much home to benefit me and my marriage. Welcome, man of God.
God bless you again.
I'm so excited.
I'm privileged to be here again.
Every time that I see you here, I know I have so much today to take it home.
Amen.
And Amen. We thank God for having you here. We believe that you are so busy, as I always say. He is so busy, you know. He's all over doing the work of God. So if we get him here, we thank God.
Amen.
And Pastor, I believe the other time when you came to the studio, we was talking about how couples will do to free from financial difficulties. As we know that so many couples are going through financial crisis, financial difficulties. There are so much going on. By the grace of God, God used you to explain so much. And we are still here because there's so much that we have to ask and just grab it again and just move forward to, you know, free ourselves for financial entanglements, Pastor. And today, the question here that we have to ask Pastor is, how can the couples help themselves to be free from financial difficulties?
How can the couples help themselves? Financial challenges is really based on the fact that we don't have a lot of incoming. Income coming in that will be able to offset the liabilities of our expenditure. So we have more expenses, much more than what we have as an income. So because of that, it brings a whole lot of pressure that is originating from our necessities and the struggles to make ends meet and rationing things in us. And there, I understand how this plays out, and sometimes it puts a strain on the relationship. So for them to be able to come to a place where they help each other to make finance and to create income, they must first recognize the potential that they have to create value for the marketplace. Everybody that is in the couple, the individuals have potential to create value, because God has invested talent, gifts in everybody. Okay, the other thing you have to understand also, their story, they've been through things that can help somebody. Not only that, their relations, they might know somebody that has the solution to somebody's problem. Okay, so what I'm listing right now their potential to create value, because somebody might say that, you know, you're talking about going to the marketplace, you're talking about all this, but I don't have nothing. So how do I make some money? Now, anytime you can solve a problem, you have the potential to start a business.
Okay, so it doesn't matter even when you are working with someone.
Let me give you an example. You are in the house and you can clean your carpet very well. You might look at it and say there's nothing to it, or there's no way, but you clean very well. What if in your neighborhood you have a lot of people, or maybe in other areas you have a lot of people who have dirty carpets who need somebody to clean it up? Now, it's a business that you can do right now and start making money. Are you getting? What if you are in a house and you write very well as a woman? Maybe the husband doesn't write well, but you are the woman, you are a good writer. But you don't do anything with it because you feel like, how am I going to make some money with writing? Money doesn't make any money. But the question is this: if you can use your writing to do research and find out solutions that you can write to solve a problem in the marketplace, you can have a book that will sell. Not just writing, but write books that has solutions that the marketplace already needs so that you can sell the books. Because a lot of people write books, they don't make money.
Okay.
Yeah. So find out, do an inventory, as I said, do an inventory about of what you, the core couple, can do right now. Mm-hmm. Your knowledge skills. What do you know? Mm-hmm. That can solve somebody's problem. Okay. People you know. Mm-hmm. Who do you know has maybe knowledge, skill, resources that can solve problem? Because if you don't have nothing, maybe you know somebody mm-hmm. who can solve somebody's problem. You can go into partnership with the person.
Okay.
And then bring the contract to the person and make some money anyway.
Okay.
All right. Mm-hmm. Then you can also think about your story. Mm. How about your skill, your talent, your knowledge,
okay.
the education that you've been through. Mm. And so we have all those things. And if you can do an inventory, write the list. Mm. First, sit down. Write the name of everybody you know and what do they do and how, what problem can they solve. Okay. That alone, we can start a business immediately.
Wow.
Number two, how about you writing your talent, your skill, your knowledge, what you know right now, write it down. I know how to clean. Okay, can that cleaning solve somebody's problem? All right. I know how to cook. Okay. Now, the kind of food you cook, is it a cuisine? Something that nobody can cook and a lot of people want that food. That alone can start a business. So everybody has the potential to start a business.
But Pastor, I'm not cutting you here. So if I have this potential,
Maybe
I know how to claim.
Yeah.
By me doing the research,
mm-hmm.
for me to know that so many people need that, then maybe mm-hmm. right now I'm so much in need that I need money.
Yeah.
I can't even pay my rent.
Yeah.
I need money right away. Mm-hmm. So is it possible that maybe I can just interact with someone that has been in this business
mm-hmm.
already,
mm-hmm.
that maybe the person can just hire me or maybe the person can give me some clients
mm-hmm.
for me to pay that person?
Mm-hmm.
When I do that, is it my own business or I'm working for someone?
When we talk about business, even if you are working 9 to 5, consider that as my own business, because you are working, you are bringing the value of your time, your skill set to the business, and they are paying you money for that.
Mm-hmm.
So in your mentality, just think about it as it's my business. I am working 9 to 5, but I'm a business person in that business.
Because you know why? Our mindset is, when I have my own business, that means I have to go to the marketplace
mm-hmm.
and do my own research and make sure that everything that you know I have is coming to me. Nobody have to be in the middleman or something like that.
No,
that
is you see, mentality. You have to understand that working for somebody sometimes puts a cap on your income. It literally restricts your time. You have to do things according to their schedule, and I understand that, which when you become an intermediary, you become liberated from all those things. So there are benefits of you having your own business. But if you go into somebody's business with the mentality that, listen, I'm doing entrepreneurship, I'm doing a business, I'm bringing value to their business, and so it's my business,
okay.
it changes your perspective and how you respond and how to react okay. in the business. So I want everybody to have that mindset.
Okay.
But that should not be the ultimate goal that you want. It can be a stepping stone.
Okay.
Because at least you are getting income.
All right. Okay.
But I believe that the right model that God has ordained for every one of us mm-hmm. is to be able to be take control of your skill set, your talent, and be able to bring value to the marketplace.
Mm-hmm.
Because you see, we know if you don't do that, then you literally limit your potential to be great. The Bible says that, seest thou a man who is diligent in his business,
okay.
will not stand before mean men, he shall stand before kings.
Mm-hmm.
Seest thou a man. That means it is something that is constant. It is, if you are a man, you see, the Bible is trying to say, watch such a man who gets into business, who is diligent.
Mm-hmm.
No matter the circumstance, he's going to rise up above everything. He will not be obscure. He will not stand before mean men, which is people of no value.
Mm-hmm.
Or people who are obscure.
Mm-hmm.
But he will stand before kings. That means he will be in the place of prominence and a place of novelty, a place of influence and dominion. And so without you doing business, how can you come to a place of leadership and influence and kings, dominion? God wants the church, the body of Christ, people, everybody listening to me. It is the heart of God that you literally take mastery of your potential and bring value to the marketplace so you can make some money.
Wow. Yeah, we're going to go to break right now. When we come back, we are going to talk about how financial difficulties has caused so many marriages at this time, or how financial difficulties has caused so many marriages, misagreement, misunderstanding coming to the marriage. Pastor Mantis, by the grace, we're going to solve all those things. So stay tuned. Don't go anywhere. We're going to be right back. Back.
Yes,
we are here. We are still, Pastor Mante is still here with us. We thank God. Yeah, Pastor. Yeah, my question again here is, how can financial difficulties, financial, you know, this disability, let me say it, in our marriages,
how can we do? Because I know that it's causing so marriages to break up. Because maybe the woman has been with the man so long, they cannot even, you know, be free from financial entanglement. They can't even do anything. And it has been causing so many marriages. So right now, my question is, why is it that we have that ideas and it's causing marriages to break because of financial difficulties?
What do you mean by ideas? I really don't understand the question.
Because the idea was the value that we have.
Okay.
Yeah, because we know that you are talking about the value. We have to make sure that everybody have value. We have to make sure that we believe that that we have value. But
so many people have that value.
But because I know that, because you said that we don't put it into practice.
Yeah.
That's why you're causing that.
Yeah.
But some people, maybe they are put into practice.
Yeah.
You know, they can be freedom from that financial difficulties.
Okay.
It's causing so many marriages.
Okay.
Because their finances always, you know, is in the...
A lot of crisis, right?
They can't even liberate from their financial crisis.
I think then that one of the things that we need to consider is this. The mere fact that you have value and you have potential does not mean that automatically it's going to bring you money. And I don't care how spiritual you are, which is something that many believers have to change their thinking. If you don't develop value to the marketplace, your spirituality will not automatically translate into income. Years ago, I was so frustrated and I needed money. And it was really a struggle. So I went to the park to pray. And in the prayer, I was really pouring my heart that God, I'm serving you well. I love you. I pray for hours. I fast. I just told my finances, my bills. Then God asked me a question. What are the books I gave you to write? Because if you write the books and you take it to the marketplace, I'll give you the money. Mm-hmm. So in our concept of thinking, in our religious kind of perception, we are thinking that the mere fact that we pray more, fast more, go to church, automatically the blessing of God will appear. But the blessing of the Lord will become a reality when you are diligent, put your hands to work. It will bless the work of your hands. Mm-hmm. So if your hands is not doing any work, although you are spiritually, you are engaged in spiritual activity, mm-hmm. it's not going to produce no results. So God blesses you. It is manifested when you are not bringing value to the marketplace.
So Pastor, are you saying that miraculously, mm-hmm. God cannot, you know, open doors for us to just, somebody should put money even in our life?
No, God will give you favor. He can send money, but that is not how he wants you to live continuously. Mm. Of course, God works miracles. Mm. He opens doors. He creates opportunities for you. But what are you going to do with the opportunity? Mm. He will literally orchestrate circumstances to bring maybe a little bit of help, or maybe help to bring some peace right now. But how about you? What are you going to do? And God's miracle is literally communicated and translated when you engage and your faith and do something.
Okay.
And you got faith activates miracles.
Okay.
But you don't wait for the miracle before you take the faith. All right. And so you don't see anything, nothing is going on, but you act out what God has placed in your life. And something else. So there are many couples who have the potential, but they don't do nothing because they are feeling like, well, I don't know what to do. I don't have what it takes. Who am I to even try to start a business because I don't have anything? Business is so simple. Market, product and services, interaction, business, money comes in. So simple, don't make it complicated. Is there a market hungry enough to pay for what you have? And there are a lot of them. And then simple thing, now that you are assured of that market, then come and develop a product and just present it to them. Don't make it complicated, because you sometimes we make it so complicated. Sometimes you want to be like somebody who's going to have a business school before you can. No, you don't have to complicate it. First, do your market research.
Wow.
Let's say that like you are a married expert. The question is, find out from your married couples that you know, three or five of them, just do research. Ask them, right now, what are your struggles that you are going through? Mm. What are the challenges? What are your problems? Then you ask them, okay, if I do a product, a service, a training, seminar, coaching, something that can literally give you the result, solve that problem, will you be willing to pay for it?
Wow.
So you ask 10 people, 9 of them say, listen, we'll pay for it right now if you give us the product.
Ooh.
Then why are you sitting down for?
Bingo.
The only thing you just have to do is come back, put the package together, put your service, and then present it to them.
Yeah.
Now the other question, if you do the research and find out that you've reached 10 people, but multiply by 1,000. What do you think is going to happen?
Wow.
And you're selling to them $100, wow. And you have 1,000 people. Hmm. You can be 100,000 people, $100,000 right now, income coming. So, ma'am, you must say that I don't have nothing. But do you have solutions to problems that can solve problems in marriages? Hmm. So why are you not bringing it to the marketplace to solve it? Why are you not selling it? Hmm. Maybe you are giving out for free. But the question is, if it's free, people will not see the value. People value what they pay for. Even if it's valuable, if it is not placed in the context of business marketing, then it is not valuable. If it's free, you are not communicating value, although what you are giving is valuable. And if they don't see the value for it, they will not pay, they will not treat it well. They will not even use it.
So couples, all that through this man of God has poured onto us today, I believe when we take those things into practice, it will help us. It will help us for us to get liberated from financial crisis, that all that worried, all that misunderstanding, all that, you know, anxiety that is going through our mind, that we feel we are not happy, we feel we are not fulfilled, we feel that we cannot even pay our rent. If we are able to embrace all these things, I believe by the time that we were done, and maybe couples, we bring our minds together as a couples to do something, God will help us. So all that ideas, by first, as the man of God said, know yourself that you have value and you know that you can do something. There are so much that God has placed in us as a couples. That's why by his grace, he brought both of you together to do great things. I believe I'm so blessed. You are blessed as you heard a man of God so much that God uses him today to say unto us, God bless you. I believe you will see him here again, and he's going to bring us so many things that we need to hear for us to go forward in our marriage, for us to be so liberated from financial crisis. God bless you. God bless you. Continue to listen to Make It Last Forever that presented financial freedom from couples. God bless you. We'll be right back.